Hi, I'm Mirko Russo from Klanglab. I help musicians and singers to get their songs produced, and I am also a musician myself. So this video is about the low end, the correct mixing of the low end. It is one of the crucial things in a mix. It can completely change the quality of your mix, whether in a positive or in a negative way. And it's not just a matter of the amount of low frequencies related to the mid-range or high frequencies. It is a little bit more complex. Indeed, a thing that everyone should be aware of is the cooperation between the kick or electronic kick and the bass or synth bass. So the main concept is the following. Since both the kick and the bass will dominate in the region from 100-120 Hz below, they must not overlap each other, to put it simply. So for instance, we need to cut a certain frequency in the kick and let the bass fill that frequency slot, and vice versa. We can do that with a bell EQ or with a high pass filter. So for instance, if you want to let the bass dominate in the region between 20 Hz and 80 Hz, you will use a high pass filter set to around 80 Hz on the kick drum. So in fewer words, you need to decide beforehand which instrument between kick and bass will dominate in the low end, and make this cut in the EQ accordingly. Otherwise, if both kick and bass are too strong in the same frequencies in the low end, your mix will sound muddy and confused. So I have an example for the treatment of the low end, but before the example, I invite you to leave a comment so that we can discuss this topic in the comment section, and to subscribe to my channel if you like the videos. So we will now hear the example. It is on a beat, and you can really understand what I'm talking about with this example. So thank you for watching, and we will see each other in the next video. Bye bye, Klanglab.